Good morning, sir. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
On this auspicious occasion, I have the great honor to kindly invite His Excellency Deputy Prime Minister, High Representative for Sentai Daijo, Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Cambodia, to deliver opening speech.
Thai Nih, Berjian Acak Kampuji Yung Men Ketiju, Rip Chom Tertul, Excellency Ligi Gabrini, Special Envoy of the Secretary General of UNWTO. Excellency Dr. U Thai Ong, Deputy Minister of Hotel and Tourism of Myanmar. Excellency Sukasam Bodhisan, Vice Chairman of Lao National Tourism Administration. Excellency Dr. Victor Wee, Chairman of Tourism Malaysia. Excellency Milau Hanam, Permanent Secretary General of Ministry of Natural Resources and Tourism of Tanzania. Excellency Thong Khon, Minister of Tourism of Cambodia. Distinguished national and international guests, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. Today, I have a great honor and pleasure to attend the opening ceremony of the Third World Ecotourism Conference 2011 under the theme Charting the Future of Ecotourism in Asia. On behalf of Samdaj Akya Mahasanapari Dicho Hun Sen, Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Cambodia, I would like to take this opportunity to warmly welcome Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, to Cambodia, particularly to this conference in the magnificent coastal resort town of Sihanoukville, located at the Cambodia Bay, a member of the most beautiful bay in the World Club. I wish to express my sincere appreciation for the concerted effort and good coordination between the Ministry of Tourism and Discovery MICE in organizing this World Ecotourism Conference 2011 in the Kingdom of Cambodia. My thanks also go to major tourism stakeholders, in particular the Ministry of Tourism, private sector, national and international development partners, as well as a local community for their endeavors in developing the emerging ecotourism in Cambodia through promoting community-based ecotourism. As reported by His Excellency Thong Khon, Minister of Tourism, this is the Third World Ecotourism Conference, following the first one in Laos in 2009 and the second one in Malaysia in 2010. As in the past, today's conference bring together tourism leaders, representatives of public and private sectors, development partners, international guest speakers, professors, researchers, civil society, local community and other tourism and ecotourism stakeholders from the region and the world. This conference provides participants with an opportunity to discuss global ecotourism development issues and to exchange their experiences and good practices in order to formulate a sound ecotourism policy aimed at ensuring efficient and sustainable management of natural resources and environment for promoting the ecotourism development. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, organizing this conference in Prasianuk province reflect commitment of the Royal Government in stimulating the green development in Cambodia, particularly in the coastal zone by ensuring the sustainable and responsible development, since the zone has already been named the Rising Star of the Southwest. Under the wise leadership of Samrat Yakeat Mahasenapadi Chu Hun Sen, Prime Minister of the Kingdom of Cambodia, Cambodian tourism, which is considered as a green goal, is one of the priority sectors contributing to socio-economic development, especially to attaining the Cambodian Millennium Development Goal, CMDGs, through creating and increasing job opportunities, generating income for the people, enhancing the on-site export, and of course, accelerating economic growth. Tourism, as one of the largest industries, has a strong social, cultural, and economic impact on the development. Without exception, this sector has achieved significant growth and become one of the major revenue generators for Cambodia. The number of international tourist arrivals in 2000 was less than 500,000. But 10 years later, in 2010, Cambodia received more than 2.5 million, as stated by Tourism Minister Thongkon, a five-fold increase, with about $1.7 billion of revenues. I think this amounting to more than 10% of our GDP. In 2011, for the first 8 months, Cambodia received more than 1.8 million of foreign tourist arrival, a 15% increase compared to the same period of 2010. I think I would like to say a few words on this. So far, you see, our main field of tourism came from cultural tourism. Yes, because we have our national heritage that become world heritage, you see, and that become a very attractive point for tourists from different continents. But now, as agency Tom Khon Yit say very clearly, you see, we register about 16% of growth in terms of number of tourists in 2010 compared to 2009. But in 2011, now is for the first month that we can calculate, you see the growth is about 15%. But I think parallelly with the growth in terms of the tourist number from the cultural tourism sector, We register also, you see, excellency here, it very clearly. You see, the growth of about 7 to 8% in this emerging ecotourism in Cambodia. That means in the coastal area, about 7%, and in the northeast area that we consider as the future site of ecotourism, you see, the growth is already about 8%. So I think this is a very good step, you see, to make our effort, you see, to push forward the ecotourism in Cambodia. However, most international tourists concentrate in a few tourist destinations only. More than 50% visit the cultural tourism site of Angkor in Siem Reap province, and approximately 40% in the capital city of Phnom Penh. Yet, natural diversity also indicates a vast biodiversity with unique flora and fauna in Cambodia. The trip to the ecotourism region in the northeast, you see, where tourists can experience indigenous culture and Mekong River dolphin watching. You see, I think this point deserves to be elaborated a little bit. You see, the northeast Asia, you see, that in Cambodia we call ASEAN region, you see, is a potential area for ecotourism. And we have one very special point. You see, our Mekong River in that area, you see, in particular Steng Trang province and Krachek province, you see, we have our what we call the freshwater dolphin. You see, that is a rare you see, in the world. According to my knowledge, maybe 4 or 5 sites only in the world that we can watch the river dolphin. You see, and river dolphin in Cambodia, you see, can provide a great potentiality, you see, to develop, I think, our ecotourism. And we have some successful stuff, you see, that has been taken, you see, and that can be, set as a success, the start of the success story. We used to get problem with the preservation of dolphin, you see. And we noticed that this problem came from the local fishermen. Yes. So we did set up a committee. Yes, the special committee. I think the chairman of the committee, he is also here. You see, he is a specialist on, fishing culture. And then we start to take measure. And one point of the success is that we can educate and encourage, you see, the people living along that area to understand the importance and the interest, you see, that can be presented, representing by the dolphin. You see, we educate them and we can turn them from fishermen to become, I think, to adopt a new job. That means to change their profession that can be dangerous, you see, for the preservation of the dolphin, you see, to adopt another profession, you see, that can be helpful to tourism. And they can prove themselves, but the new job, the new profession can bring them good revenue, better revenue than before, you see, and in a very, what we call, a coherent situation, social situation. So this is the successful step, you see, that Cambodia can be proud, you see, to share with our colleague, with our partner, with our friend, you see, some successful step that we have taken in trying to push forward to develop ecotourism in Cambodia. Yes. the Tonle Sap Great Lake. Tonle Sap Great Lake, I think we did see some picture, you see. In Tonle Sap, myself, I did experience. I did invite, I think, some dignitary from the World Heritage Committee, from UNESCO, to visit Tonle Sap. And in particular, is it to visit the bird sanctuary. I think the very quiet place, beautiful nature, very, I think, limpid water with good forest, aquatic forestry. And they can witness, I think, thousands of birds, all variety of birds. And they told me immediately, they said, you can, I think you can develop this into a kind of ecotourism, because not much in the world not this kind of site, you see, is not much in the world that we can offer, you see, to the people, to the potential tourists, you see, to enjoy, you see, to enjoy this kind of scenery. Yes, and also there is the Tonle Sap Great Lake with bird sanctuary, and also with some typical fishing village on the water. Yes. In this regard, it is important for Cambodia to diversify tourist destination while embracing its cultural tourism by promoting ecotourism, which will play an increasing role in Cambodian tourism sector, especially contributes to achieving the optimistic vision in obtaining 4.5 million of tourists in 2015 and 7 million tourists in 2020. You see, to add to my example that we did, raise, in the northeast area, you see, we also have taken, in particular, you see, with the ministry, leading ministry, Ministry of Tourism, they to try to, I think we can say the word educate, you see, and encourage people to change their mind for contributing to ecotourism. For example, you see, the minority ethnic, they used to do the hunting. The hunting, that means to kill the wild animal. But now some community, you see, they change their mind to do what? To preserve this wild animal and organize tourists to watch them. I think it is a good step for ecotourism, you see, and we attract more and more tourists, you see, and the community, they can get much better revenue, you see. There is a step in the poverty alleviation, and also they feel their life, you see, more coherent within the community. You see, so I think this is also the very good step that the ministry work together with the local authority, you see, and it is a successful step. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, the sustainable and responsible ecotourism development has been considered as a standard tool for maintaining socio-economic development and environmental sustainability. Indeed, if well managed, the ecotourism development not only contributes to the alleviation of poverty and people integration by providing economic benefits to local communities, but also to the environmental and natural resource preservation by reaching out to and providing them education and knowledge on how to live in a harmonious way with the environment while sustainably and responsibly benefiting from it. Today, you see, we have also a forum, you see, in Phnom Penh, you see, about climate change. It's about global warming, climate change. So there is a good contribution to the environment preservation. In this context, ecotourism could also play a vital role in the preservation of cultural and traditional heritages through the participation of local communities, that is, the development for preservation and the preservation for development. In achieving common goal of sustainable ecotourism, development experiences in many parts of the world have shown that a multi-stakeholder approach of an equal partnership in a tripartite relationship should be properly implemented. Where ecotourism is a government-led, private sector-driven, and community or people base, which is known as PPP, that means 4P, model, or public-private-people partnership. Therefore, ecotourism development that benefit positively to the economy, society, and environment involve the attention and participation of all stakeholders. You see, in the general term, when we speak about investment, we used to speak about 3P. PPP, that means public, private partnership. But here in the field of ecotourism, we have to add one more P, that means 4P. Public, private, people, partnership. So I think this is also a point that merit to be mentioned. Furthermore, to ensure the effectiveness of the ecotourism development process, particularly in the difficult period of global economic and financial crisis, a mixed development model should be considered. The small-scale development model, based on the activity of local tourism and ecotourism communities, and the large-scale development model, focusing on private investment by using high-end technology in compliance with environmental preservation norms. At the same time, successful implementation of both models require the preparation and reinforcement of legal frameworks and regulation, policy and strategy, such as the national policy of ecotourism, the National Strategy and Action Plan of Ecotourism Development, Eco Certification, Eco Label of Ecotourism Resort, Guideline for Management and Development of Small-Scale Ecotourism, CBET Guideline, Ecotourism Investment Guideline, Norm and Construction Standard in the ecotourism region, and the mechanism for monitoring the ecotourism development. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, you see, Dr. Thong Khon did mention about the future Siem Reap declaration on ecotourism. I think this is the idea in this direction. You see, so rule, guideline, policy, strategy should be set up. You see, and I think that this Siem Reap declaration will be a very good step. Very good step, you see, to promote in a sustainable way ecotourism in Cambodia. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, taking this opportunity, I would like to share some thought and recommendation as an input for the discussion in the conference as follows. You will have a fruitful discussion, you see, in the next few hours, you see, maybe within 2-3 days. Yes. But why I would like to suggest some point. Yeah. Point one, to increase the possibility for businesses and investment in ecotourism resort. It is important to attract operators to invest in the tourism activities and businesses in ecotourism sites by ensuring that those ecotourism resorts or able to sufficiently provide quality services to the tourists. In this spirit, the incentive for investors in the ecotourism region should be considered. Point two, to ensure the quality of product and services in the ecotourism resort. The quality of product and services provided to tourists in the ecotourism resort must be ensured. This requires the preparation of some necessary mechanisms, such as environmental standards, especially for ecotourism resort, eco label for ecotourism resort, promotion of training and capacity building for operators and the capacity building for tour guide in the ecotourism resort. Point three, to ensure safety for tourists in ecotourism. We did speak about quality, you see now we come to safety. The safety for tourists is one of the challenges that require high attention in some ecotourist sites. Thus, the reliable and affordable tourism system need to be set up, assuring the timely rescue in case of need. Tour guide, for instance, should be at least trained on how to provide the first aid. Point four, to enhance the marketing and promotion of ecotourism. Ecotourism and emerging market of the 21st century require to be widely promoted. The linkages to the global marketplace of ecotourism sites are extremely important for the development of new ecotourism destinations, particularly for the newly emerging economies. In this sense, concerted effort in the region is a must in charting the future of ecotourism in Asia and for our Asia to become one of the largest and most attractive ecotourism destinations in the world. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, to make this important even fruitful, may I encourage all distinguished participants, speakers, and all stakeholders to learn and network to share your views, knowledge, and experience, and engage in active discussion so that we together can define the right policy for ecotourism development in the region. I believe this conference will provide invaluable input for the Sihanoukville Declaration on multilateral collaboration on ecotourism development. And I hope it is a very good step, very good opportunity, you see, that we can work together to promote ecotourism, which will provide a concrete roadmap for developing sustainable and responsible ecotourism in Asia. Finally, I wish the conference every success and all delegates and participants joyful and memorable stay in Cambodia, the Kingdom of Wonder. I now declare the opening of the Third World Ecotourism Conference 2011. Thank you for your attention.
Sau phần mềm về cổng, hãy chấp thuận quyền sản phẩm rõ đồng chất con cùi. សម្បត្តិជាស្រមាក់ជាមួយនឹងឆ្នេរខ្សាច់សស្អាតដែលរួមមានលម្អរបស់កម្ពុជានិងប្រជាជនកម្ពុជាដែលរ៉ាណេនេះមានរដូវអាចារ្យធម្មជាតិចុងក្រោយតែនេះបានសាកជាប់យ៉ាងស្អិតរមួតជាមួយនឹងវប្បធម៌ជំនឿនិងទំនៀមទម្លាប់របស់ប្រជាជនតាមតំបន់នោះ ទុនទានទាំងនេះសុទ្ធសឹងជាភាពសំនៃក្រុមសាននិងមានការអេកូទេសចរកម្ពុជានិងបានរួមរួមប្រាក់ខ្លាយកម្ពុជាអំពីជាគោលដៅអេកូទេសចរដ៏ទាក់ទាញមួយដែលប្រកបដោយបទពិសោធន៍ថ្មីថ្មីនិងពោរពេញទៅដោយការទទួលរាក់ទាក់យ៉ាងកក់ក្តៅដែលចេញពីសំណាក់ម្ចាស់ក្រុមហ៊ុនជាតិនៅទីនោះកម្ពុជាមានពលសកម្មនិពន្ធអេកូទេសចរចំនួន4កន្លែងគូភីអេសាន ជារមណីយដ្ឋានអ្នកកសិកម្មដ៏សានដំណងភូមិពាន់អំអរដល់ភ្នំនិងខ្ពង់រាបដែលជាទីតាំងភូមិសាស្ត្រដែលសម្បូរទៅដោយទឹកធ្លាក់ដំណើរធម្មជាតិដ៏ស្មុគស្មាញបានលក្ខណៈអាចម្បាំងនៃជំនាញសំណងប្រពៃណីកុលសម្ព័ន្ធជនជាតិភាគតិចដូចជាអំបូរភ្នំគួយសំរាមដំណើរទស្សនាចរតាមច្រកអំពីធម្មជាតិមានត្រូវខាងកើតដែលនៅអបក្រុមនិងខ្សែទឹកទន្លេមេគង្គ ស្នាក់នៅរួមរស់ជាអាហារប្រពៃណីខ្មែរប្រចាំតំបន់រមន់ជួយពេញបឹងទន្លេសាបជារមន់អភិរក្សជីវៈចម្រុះនិងជាប្រភពនៃជីវិតវត្តពិសោធន៍នៃដំណើរទស្សនាចរតាមដងបឹងទន្លេសាបទស្សនាភូមិបណ្ដែតទឹកដែលជាប្រភពនៃផ្សែងមួយនៅក្នុងតំបន់ទស្សនាទីសក្ការៈដែលទីតាំងនៅលើទួលកណ្ដាលទឹករមន់ជួបក្នុងក្រវ៉ាន់ រូបនាមប្រមួយភាគរយនៃប្រទេសកម្ពុជាជាជំរុំប្រេងធំជាបៃតងស្រងាត់និងជាជំរុំសត្វដែលជិតផុសពូជជាច្រើនប្រភេទជាទីរំលីដែលដល់ឲ្យទេសចរមើលការកំសាន្តនិងបទពិសោធន៍ថ្មីៗជាច្រើនដូចជាការជិះកង់តាមជ្រលងភ្នំការទស្សនាភ្នំបុរាណការជិះទូកកូនសត្វព្រៃនៅបាក់សើជំរុំពណ៌នៅតាមដងព្រែកការទស្សនាអង្គរអំពើនាពេលរាត្រី ដែលមានការចូលរួមក្នុងសកម្មភាពប្រជាជនក្នុងតំបន់ទាំងកម្លាំងនិងស្មារតីរួមតាមនិន្នាការប្រកបដោយនិរន្តរភាពនិងដើម្បីចូលរួមការពារជីវៈចម្រុះព្រមទាំងប្រជាប្រឆាំងនឹងការបំផ្លាញធនធានធម្មជាតិតាមគ្រប់រូបភាពឆ្នេរសមុទ្រកម្ពុជាតារារះនិងទីភ្នាក់ងារនៃជាគោលដៅអេកូទេសចរថ្មីជាមួយនឹងការអនុវត្តទស្សនវិជ្ជាថ្មីក្នុងសារនឹងការជំរុញមនុស្សវិទ្យាធម្មជាតិដល់ការពារនិងតាមដានតាមនេះជាមួយនឹងសេវាកម្មលំដាប់ថ្នាក់អន្តរជាត ដែលបានជួយដល់ការអភិវឌ្ឍន៍សេដ្ឋកិច្ចនិងសន្តិភាពនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាសូមយកខ្យល់បរិសុទ្ធនិងសម្រាប់អាហារនិងភេសជ្ជៈតាមបែបប្រពៃណីគូស្នេហ៍ថ្មីតងដ៏អធិមានប្រកបអាកម្បាំងប្រវត្តិសាស្ត្រជាច្រើន
Tak tahu ni. Tak tahu tak. 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 I see.
Đặc biệt là những vấn đề tạo nên
ba số ba
đây là
chen
của
họ
nó
thay
đổi
cái công việc đó thì
chúng
ta phải biết
là people the now
care for
một à một chốt
Stomach. Okay. Like a tea. Like a tea.